shot by your boy Toon Dollars.
What's up, y'all? This is how we gonna start today's vlog.
So with the last scene of the day. You guys just witnessed an exclusive 8-second clip of Dark Stack's latest music video shot by your boy Toon Dollars under my new brand Beyond the Sky Media. Make sure you follow I Am Dark Stacks to see when the video gets released.
Finally getting around to this oil change. It was due for one almost like all year. What's up, y'all? This is how we gonna start today's vlog. It's like 2 degrees outside, so it ain't like 2 degrees, but damn, look how black that oil is. Oil is sludgy.
I believe that every gentleman should know how to change their own oil and filter.
Lefty loosey, righty tighty.
All right, so my job here is done. The oil looked horrible, like that's a disgrace.
Yeah, we all good to go, y'all.
So with the last scene of the day, I'm gonna show you guys this new score I got.
Well, it's new to me. It's probably old to some of the OG vintage collectors out there. But check this out. I got this for a dirt cheap price, guys. I mean, dirt cheap. And I say dirt cheap because when I look these up to see what they go online for, I seen these Columbia brand bikes go anywhere from as low as $250, $300 to $600, $700. I saw one for $1,200. I saw some in the $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000 range. Obviously, price is gonna weigh fairly on the condition of the bike and how original the bike is. This looks to be original for the most part. Took a real good look at everything on it and it seems to be original. Be nice if there's an appraiser or an antique collector that happens to see this video that could give me their recommendation. But compared to what I paid for it, I'm sure that I got this for an excellent deal. Check it out, guys. This is in the 1960s. I believe this is like a 66, 67. I did a little bit of research to try to find more information on it. I'm not sure if these tires are the original tires from back in the day. It's a good chance they could be. You got a little bit of dry rot, a little cracking, nothing serious. They both hold air. It's extremely dusty. The person I got it from had it in storage. So there's a thin layer of dust everywhere. It's not shining to the maximum potential right now. It has dust. It has a small, maybe hairline rust here and there. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit it with some SOS pads and try to bring this thing back to life. I'm gonna clean up the chrome with SOS pads and then I'll probably just hit the painted surface with some soap, you know, sponging water and some soap and try to shammy it up and dry it up. It has the original headlight here. See the original headlight and then that's the switch. You turn on the original headlight. The original headlight has a small crack on the left side, but it doesn't seem to be anything major. That's something you can probably get from eBay. Maybe there's another collector out there that has one of these or has a parts bike and may be able to sell you that front cover. But everything else looks pretty darn neat. It even has the original horn, but the original horn is missing the end piece. I wonder if any end piece would work on that, right? Like if I go to Walmart and if I got one of their horns and just took the black end piece and put it on that, would it still work? But check it out. Got the original horn, original handlebars, original grips. I'm assuming they're the original grips because the seat matches. The original seat has the springs on the bottom. When I rode this thing, let me tell you how it kind of shifts with your weight. When you're pedaling, like left foot, right foot, when you pedal left, your body shifts right. When you pedal right, your body shifts left. So that's pretty neat. The frame, the stylizing of the frame is incredible. See all the dust? But overall, y'all, this thing is beautiful. I got a couple little scrapes here and there. Check it out. A little scrape there, a little scrape there. So I just want to show it to you guys right now because tomorrow I'm probably just going to give you guys a sneak peek at what it looks like clean. I'll clean it up. This will be part one. We'll call this part one. Tomorrow when you come back to part two, this bike should be looking a lot better. You guys want me to flip it around, right? They're like, Toon, we want to see the other side. Let us see the chain guard before you go. Chain guard in full effect. Y'all ready to see it, right? Check it out. Original chain guard. That crank should be original too, right? The star and the crank. Yeah, it's pretty neat, man. All the original stickers. They kept it in okay condition. It's not that bad. I guess it could have been worse considering the age. But this is what? A 45, 50 year old bike almost? This thing's older than me. So I think that's cool. I've always been fascinated by old vintage memorabilia or like things from the past. I don't know if this lock is from back in the day. I'm not sure. I was thinking about cutting it off because it's a combination lock, but I don't know. It might add to the vintage look. Yeah, guys, this was one heck of a score. One man's trash is another man's treasure. And in this case, I found a treasure indeed.
This vlog was not sponsored by Brillo Pads.
But come back to tomorrow's vlog and watch how shiny I have this thing looking with the Brillo Pads. Son.